Hello and welcome to my channel. Over the years I collected a lot of watercolors. I own a lot of brands and a lot of different colors. It might be very convenient to own a lot of colors, but I realized that I became lazy mixing them. That's why I came up with the idea to do a series about limited palettes. Today I attempt to paint with the so-called Zorn palette. This palette is named after the Swedish artist Anders Leonard Zorn. He was known for using a very limited palette consisting of cadmium red medium, yellow ochre, ivory black and white. Although it's not sure if he used only these four colors, in some paintings you can see, for example, more vivid blues. Anyways, it's not important in this case, it's just a good practice to use a limited palette. Now back to my own little Zorn palette. It's a tiny bit different from the original Zorn palette. Because I don't like using ivory black in watercolor paintings, I purchased Payne's Gray instead, because it has a bluish tint. Also, I never use white in my watercolor paintings, but for the sake of experimenting, I included in Shinhan Pass white. Shinhan Pass colors are hybrids of watercolor and gouache. I thought that might be interesting because I could use the white as a transparent and an opaque color. The other three colors are by Rembrandt, a brand I never used before, but I like it so far. As you can see, I swatched out the different color combinations I can achieve with this little set. In hindsight, I'm not sure if this grid made any sense. My swatches are usually more basic. Little fun fact, Zorn isn't just the name of the painter, it's also a German word. It means anger or rage. So it's kind of funny to paint with a Zorn palette because it sounds like I'm painting with very angry colors. After swatching all the different color combinations, I started my first sketch. I loved to sketch with the Prismacolor Calirase pencils the most. For this sketch and the following ones, I chose to use Carmine Red. To be honest, I felt quickly very unsatisfied with the sketch. I'm still not used to paint or draw in front of the camera, so I felt very pressured and messed up, in my opinion at least. Also, I wasn't satisfied with the quality of the sketchbook paper anymore. I don't necessarily think it's bad paper. I recently upgraded to Archer's cotton paper and that stuff spoiled me rotten. Seriously, it's really hard to get back to normal cellulose paper after you tried it, especially when you use a lot of heavy washes and layer a lot. Since I'm the cliché of a starving artist, I don't even own the most expensive kind of Archer's paper. I was so unhappy with this painting in an early stage that I decided to move on and start another one. After feeling so pressured and unsatisfied with the first sketch, I decided to draw the next one off camera. Even though I know it's kind of stupid to feel pressured in front of the camera, because I could cut everything out I want and no one's actually watching me. I still feel very tense and have problems relaxing, especially at the beginning of the video. Do you hate to feel watched while drawing as well? For my second sketch, I decided to leave my sketchbook behind and use Hahnemühle Britannia paper instead. To be more precise, it's also on cellulose paper in 300 GSM, and it's hot pressed. Since I use color pencils in combination with watercolor, less textured paper works better for me. This paper is very smooth and performs fine, but I don't know how many layers it could take. Generally, Hahnemühle is a very reliable and great brand, and it's also highly available and affordable in Germany. As I said before, I usually combine color pencils with watercolor. My favorite color pencils are Polychromos by Faber-Castell. Since I wanted to be consistent with my limited palette, I only used light yellow ochre, scarlet red, which is also yellowish red, like cadmium red, and Payne's gray. Additionally, I used a colorless blender pen by Lyra. Sometimes I love to add gold to my illustrations. Because this little demon girl wears a lot of accessories, it was quite convenient to do so in this case. Is using gold paint cheating? I don't know. Anyways, I used a very old tube of golden gouache paint and I wasn't that satisfied. I prefer fine tech colors. The second sketch with my Zorn palette is nearly finished, so let me talk about my experience with this limited palette. Was it difficult? Yes and no. I'm used to use a lot of cadmium red and yellow ochre because I mainly paint faces. Usually I would add more deeper reds and violets like alizarin crimson and quinacridone violet to deepen the shadows and to give the face more values. The most challenging part of this palette was to incorporate the Payne's gray and the white. The reason for that is simply because I'm not used to it, I guess. For me, Payne's gray is primarily a substitute for black. And white I don't use at all in my watercolor pieces. In conclusion, I really like to experiment with this limited palette, and I definitely will do more. My third and last sketch for this video is this little bunny girl. I chose to paint her because the day I was recording was Easter Monday. On Sunday I visited my family and Monday was fully dedicated to art, recording and editing. How did you spend your holidays? Also, I'd like to know about your experiences with the Zorn or other limited palettes. By the way, the second and the third illustration will be available in my shop for an affordable price. If you're interested, check out the link in the description below. My favorite sketch in this video was the second one. Which is your favorite? If you enjoyed this video, please consider to like and subscribe. I try to upload more frequently, but my limited equipment makes it a real hassle and very time consuming. Have a nice day, thank you for watching, and hopefully until next time.